Hello everyone, it's Shannon here for Spellbinders. In today's video, we're going to do some no-line watercoloring to this gorgeous image included in the November stamp of the month. I'm going to start by taking a closer look at this new stamp set. I love the focal image and the additional florals, great for creating backgrounds, and there's really some beautiful scripty sentiments in that set as well. I'm going to stamp that main focal image onto some Bristol paper. If you're not familiar with Bristol paper, it's a very smooth paper and it's going to allow my watercoloring or my low water watercoloring really to kind of glide over the surface so I can get these nice gradations. I'm going to ink up that focal image in a very light ink and then just stamp it on to the front of my panel. You want to just use some sort of light dye ink. It doesn't really matter too much what it is. So now that I've got my image stamped, I'm going to kind of take some of my markers. I'm going to use Tombow door brush pens and color on to my work surface here, and then I'll take with my brush with only a small amount of water added to it, pick up some of that ink and start to add color to the base of each one of the petals on this poinsettia. Now I'm using very little water. I can't stress enough how little water I am actually using to get this ink kind of moving. I even have water sprayed out onto my work surface, and I will just dip my brush into just a small droplet of water, and that's kind of how I really ensure I'm using very little water, because it doesn't take much to really get this ink kind of moving. So now I'm moving on to kind of blending out these petals. I am loading my brush up with a little bit of water and a little bit more ink, so it's kind of a softer, lighter pink, and then kind of going back over where I put that color down at the base and blending it out to create a nice soft gradation over those petals. So I just finished up a series of four or five. I'm now going to start working on a few more, doing these kind of one by one this time. So starting at the base, getting that color down, and then cleaning my brush, and then blending it out with just a very light pink. So now I'm quickly going to do the center. I just colored it yellow and then added kind of an orange couple dots just to kind of make it a little bit more interesting. I went ahead and finished the second poinsettia, and now I'm going to basically repeat this process for these other flowers at the top of the crystal. I am starting at the base again with my color, and then cleaning my brush, and then with that watered down red, which is the pink, kind of blending it out to create a gradation. I'm now going to move on to these leaves. Now I have two colors picked out. I'm starting out with my darker color, coloring at the base of the leaf where it's kind of up against the flower, and then blending it out to create a nice soft gradation, just the same manner that I did the petals. Once I finish with that green, I'm going to move to my lighter green, this kind of lime green, start at the end of the petal or end of the leaf and kind of work up to the base, and that just creates a nice transition between these two greens, a nice gradation or ombre kind of look over the leaf. I'm going to actually use these exact same inks for this kind of pine sprig up here at the top. I started with my darker color, colored in kind of the spine of this pine sprigs, and then even added some needles. And then after I got some of that base color down, I then went to that lime green, started at the end of the sprigs, and then worked towards the base of them just to kind of, again, create a nice gradation between those two colors. I'm now going to move on to a grouping of berries. I'm just going to color the bottom curve of the berries, or the underside of the berries, with this really pretty purple color. And once I get that color down, I'll then take my damp brush, just go over where that color is, kind of blend it out over the berry. I'll repeat that process for all the berries over in that corner. Now for this little section, this is a little bit of mistletoe, so there are berries here too, but I just used a really, really light blue just to add a bit of color, and keeping those basically so they look kind of white. And now moving on to my final green, and I'm just going to color in the kind of stems and the leaves, the little base of the leaves of this mistletoe with this green, and then I'll blend it out with my damp brush. I also am going to use this same green here for the leaves up here with these top red flowers, again coloring with the marker direct to paper here, actually the base of these leaves, and then blending them out with my brush. I kind of go back and forth between direct to paper with the marker, or sometimes with the brush. Here I'm going again direct to paper with the marker just to add a stem to all the little berries here, and that actually complete kind of all my florals for this. So now it's time for the crystal. Now for the crystal, I'm going to use that same light blue color that I used on the mistletoe and color in kind of the base of this front facet of the crystal. Then I'll move to this really dark blue. I'm going to apply it at the very tip of this front facet of the crystal, and then I'll go up into the upper left corner here and apply it, and then I'll start to blend it out. So once I get some of that color down there, I'll then clean my brush and start to blend it out to again create a nice kind of transition between that darker blue and that kind of lighter blue. I'm now working over on another facet of this crystal. Here I'm going to again use those two same colors, but I'm starting to get mindful of putting darks near lights when I move to the opposite facet. So I'm like right here at this top facet here, I went to that lighter blue right against where that darker blue was on that very first facet that I did. So basically a lot of contrast here between your facets, especially when they're adjacent to each other, is going to really help you out. It's going to help define those faces of the crystal. And I'm using tumble drill brush pens, but you can use other water-based markers. They would work for this technique, like Zigs. I just really like using my tumble drill brush pens. They work. I find them really easy to work with. So I'm just finishing up here these last couple of facets, and I'm now ready to move on to stamping my sentiment. So I have my image here back in my Misti. Now I did make sure it's really dry. Actually, hit it with my heat gun just a bit to make sure all that watercoloring was dry, because I'm going to do some embossing. So I put down some anti-static powder, inked up my sentiment in Versamark ink, and now I'm going to pour on some clear embossing powder just to add a little bit of shine to this, and a little bit of dimension as well to this image. So now that that is heat set, I'm going to actually fussy cut this out. It's actually pretty easy to do. There's only a couple little tricky areas. I do leave a white border, and you could definitely skip this step. There's no need to actually fussy cut it out, but I wanted to have a little bit more contrast with the background. So I'm going to place this on a piece of colored cardstock for some more contrast. So there it is, all fussy cut out. Now we're ready to kind of bring it together. So I'm going to use a really kind of minty light green. I think it kind of pairs nicely with the colors and still has kind of a cool Christmassy feel. I just used some tape and stuck it down to an A2 top folding white card base. I did add some foam adhesive to the backside of my crystal, and I'll just stick that down. That actually completes my card. And I'll hold it to the camera so you can get a good look at all of the details in this really beautiful image. I really love watercoloring florals, especially these really detailed florals. I think it really highlights all the texture and lines in the image. I hope you guys enjoyed today's card and video. If you'd like any more information on the products I use, please head over to Spellbinders. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.